Canada, our home and native land. True patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, our true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
got to get the contest because right now we're not getting anything.
Yeah, I mean, we have some going on.
They're not sending us the feed from downstairs. Mike's not down there. It's beyond my control. It's nothing to do with me. Just tell us beyond our control.
Mike is not even up here. He's just not to go.
Yeah, it's beyond our control.
All Mike's saying to me is it's beyond our control. Mike's coming.
There's nothing we can do about it except for Mike.
Zimmerman to Jones. Jones setting up top. Dishes to Tanner Giddings, looking for some support. Giddings cuts to the left, switches with Massey back to Giddings. Turnaround jumper off the back of the rim and no good. Back up the floor. Williams grabs that. Williamson with the ball now. Back to Williams Jr. Ball gets caught inside. Good defense by Cape Breton. Back on the floor to Williams Jr. Williams backs off. Right across, 1-8 on the shot clock. Wow, from way downtown, that's Maurice Bolton. There's Taquan Zimmerman and Jones teaming up. Jones heads right to the key. Giddings comes out to set a screen, and he does. Creates some room for Zimmerman. Zimmerman decides to pull up and shoot himself off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound grabbed by Williamson with the ball, number 15, running in. And beautiful play over the top, finger roll. Highlanders grab a timeout at 7:51. London Lightning 12, Cape Breton Highlanders 6.
Fans, here's your chance to support the local cause. Somebody here with some money.
You weren't coming through. Volunteers
are coming. So you're on now.
Thanks.
Okay. And this one's off. Just remember. Okay.
The winner will be announced to you on the floor.
Good to go.
Get your tickets now.
Hi, folks. Sorry, I understand there wasn't much audio until a moment ago. I'll welcome you all, as I did off the top, to this National Basketball League of Canada matchup between the home team, the Cape Breton Highlanders, and the defending champions, 2017-18 champion London Lightning. We've got a nice crowd on hand here at Centre 200 to see this matchup. Cape Breton Highlanders coming off an emotional win in their home opener last night, where they defeated the Kitchener-Waterloo Titans. To set the scene for you, the Cape Breton Highlanders went to the dressing room at halftime down 21 and turned it around, played amazing defense, finally got some buckets to go, and the game came down right to the very end. Tied at 108, 3.7 seconds on the clock. The captain of the Cape Breton Highlanders, Bruce Massey, runs the floor with 3.7, tries to get a shot off as the buzzer went to zero, tried to get a three-point shot off, and was fouled in the act of shooting, so went to the line uncontested to shoot three. And he made two of those three to win the game 110-108. What a win last night. Right to the wire, as most of these games go. I want to welcome viewers across Cape Breton and around the world, including our friends from the band Pretty Archie, who are on tour with their successful new album they just released. They're out touring Saskatchewan, Alberta, BC, and points beyond. So we wish them the best of luck. Hopefully they'll be able to play here with the folks at Centre 200 at a Highlanders game someday. Down the line goes Williamson. He kicks it back to Phillips, who's into the game for London. He's off the front of the rim and no good. Marvin Phillips, a Jacksonville, North Carolina native. 6'7 forward. You just watch Bruce Massey do what he does best. Challenge the tallest guy on the team and put it in over him. That's Massey for two. Marvin Phillips takes a foul. He's new into the game. Massey to the line to shoot. Massey makes it a three-point play, and now it's a three-point game. 12-9, London. Into the game, number 14 from Winter Haven, Florida, Marcus Capers. Well, this should be a home game for him because this place is full of Capers. Welcome to Cape Breton, Marcus. There's Moon. He swings it way over to Bolden, fakes right inside to Phillips. Off the glass and good. Good eyes by Bolden to see an open Phillips underneath. He faked it to kick for the three and fed it right into the paint. Resulted in two. There's Zimmerman back to Jones for Cape Breton on offense. Jones, Zimmerman loves to shoot three over the top of his defender, off the front of the rim, no good. There's Bolden with another defensive board. Bolden to Phillips. Nice steal by Bruce Massey. Eyes inside to Reynolds, and he jams it! Jamal Reynolds for two! Capers to Phillips. Moon fakes the three, right to the baseline. Beautiful play by Bolden at the baseline to put it in for two. Referee Ryan Lutz calling a foul on Marvin Phillips. To the line, number 21, 6'6 forward, Wyandanch, New York, Kenny Jones. Jabari Craig steps into the game for Cape Breton, and Justin Taylor as well. Jabari Craig's number 22. He's a center from 6'10 center from Toronto, Ontario. To the line. Kentucky State University's youngest inductee into the Hall of Fame, which happened earlier this year. Kenny Jones. Last time Kenny Jones played in this league, he led all scoring 3 years ago. He went to Argentina and played for two seasons, and he's back in the NBLC playing for the Cape Breton Highlanders. He makes his first free throw. And he makes the second one. Anthony A.J. Gaines Jr. into the game for London Lightning, number 35. Shreveport, Louisiana native 6'4 guard, A.J. Gaines Jr. And they're going to call a offensive foul. Stepping into the game, A.J. Gaines Jr. gets a foul as soon as he comes in, and an offensive foul nonetheless. That's three team fouls for London. 5:52 remaining in the first period here. London 16, Cape Breton 13. Justin Taylor with the ball. That's number three, Justin Taylor from Lexington, Kentucky. He's a 6'4 guard and a new addition to the Cape Breton Highlanders this 2018-19 season. Well, it's turned right over. Gaines Jr. takes it under. He kind of submarines Massey. And they're going to get that back. Highlanders are going to take that ball. Gaines Jr. tried to submarine Massey there and lost control of the ball. It went out of bounds. I'm sorry, that's Lightning ball. Correction on the baseline. Ware Jr. underneath the Phillips, and he jams it home for two. ...18-13 now, 5:21 left in this first quarter. There's Justin Taylor running the floor with Moon on him. He makes a nice move on Moon, cuts in, dishes. Jamal Reynolds looking for Kenny Jones inside. Nope, but there's Jones right at the free throw line, cuts inside, off the glass, and good. That's Kenny Jones for two. That's his second consecutive basket. Xavier Moon double-teamed, dishes to the corner. Ware, Kevin Ware Jr. with the ball. There comes Marvin, gonna play a screen, but no, calls him off, double-teamed. Back to Phillips, uncontested look, but a hand in his face, but what a shot by Phillips. Justin Taylor, slips on the floor. Keeps his balance, though. He's all tied up. Good pass inside to Jamal Reynolds. Takes it to the glass and good. That's Reynolds. Makes his presence known in this game. Xavier Moon with the ball. Over to Capers. Capers in the corner to Ware Jr. Way long. Kenny Jones with the defensive rebound. Gives it to Taylor. Puts it back on the floor to Bruce Massey. He's feeling a three. Oh, off the front of the rim. D rebound by Phillips. He gives it to Capers. Off the rim and no good. Shot by Moon. And oh, there's Jamal Reynolds having a tough time getting a hold of that ball. And he's fouled in the act of shooting. He'll shoot two. That's Kevin Ware Jr. getting the foul on a block. That will send number nine, Jamal Reynolds, to the line. 6'5 forward from Toronto, Ontario. The spark plug, the ever ready battery bunny of this team. Full of energy. Exciting player to watch. Here he is for two. Nothing but mesh. In and out. He makes one of two. Xavier Moon takes the ball up court. Nice pick by Williams. Kicked out to the corner. Capers back to the top. I should say Bolden. Bolden to Gaines Jr. He tries it from the corner. No good. Rebound by Jamal Reynolds. He runs the floor, sees Massey in full flight, and he's fouled in the act of shooting by Maurice Bolden. That'll send Bruce Massey to the line to shoot two. Massey's good for the first one. Chris Johnson steps back in for Cape Breton. Number 23. Back to the line to shoot his second free throw. Bruce Massey. And he gets it. That's two. We got a one-point game, 21-20 for the Lightning. Nice defense by Jamal, but he's going to get called for the push in the back, I think. That'll be a foul to number 22, Jabari Craig. That won't be a shooting foul, so it's only the second foul for the Cape Breton Highlanders in this game. 3:22 left in the first quarter. Marcus Capers to inbound. He finds Moon, and that's going to call. They're going to call another offensive foul there. Justin Taylor made an audible sound as he got crossed up with Kirk Williams Jr. took that foul. That's a turnover on foul. Will be an inbound by Jamal Reynolds. He'll inbound to Justin Taylor, who will take it across center, and Cape Breton will set up for an. It's all cleared out in the middle right now. Justin's decided to run right downtown. Gives it to Chris Johnson. Sees some space. Athletic off the glass, but no good. Bolden with the defensive board. He feeds it to Capers, takes it up the floor. Capers to Bolden for three. Nice look off the front of the rim, no good. Nice tip by Johnson to Massey. Massey pulls up for two, feeling it all day long. Cape Breton takes the lead for the first lead of the game for the Cape Breton Highlanders, 22-21. I don't know if Williams Jr. tries it, no good. Another great rebound by they're going to call Justin Taylor on the push. London Lightning will get the ball in the baseline in the offensive zone. Marcus Capers to inbound. Kevin Thomas subs into the game. Taking out Kirk Williams Jr. Kevin Thomas is 6'8 forward from Ajax, Ontario. Williams Jr. grimacing as he comes off the floor. Nice Nice two-pointer by A.J. Gaines Jr. there. We're going to call Chris Johnson out of bounds. His foot was out of bounds when he took that pass, so that's a turnover. 23-22 with 2:22 left in the first quarter. Thomas inbounds to number 14, Marcus Capers. Oh, inside. Good block by Jamal Reynolds to keep that ball out of the hands. And they're going to call turn. They're going to call another foul on Justin Taylor, another push. Well, it wasn't in the act of shooting. That's the fourth team foul for Cape Breton. Well, Capers, as I said earlier, maybe when the audio was not on. Marcus Capers. Nice inside. Oh, and you're going to call a trip there on Williamson. I think that'll be Bruce Massey. That's a block. Thanks to everyone on YouTube for watching the game today. If you have any comments or questions about what's going on here at the game, feel free to fire your questions online, and I'll be sure to try and answer them for you. Coach Keith Vassell giving some instructions to Anthony A.J. Gaines Jr. as Williamson makes the free throw. 24-22, 2:07 left in the first quarter. Williamson with his second. And he makes it. Justin Taylor getting into a little foul trouble here, but he's got the ball on offense for Cape Breton with 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Pretty good game on the go here. Switches with Reynolds. Reynolds looks to take it to the hoop like he always does, off the glass, and oh, unfortunate, but good. Kenny Jones looks to get the rebound. Well, there it is. Look at that. That's tenacious D by Cape Breton. Full shot clock back. Massey, I should say. Massey working on Bolden, pulls up over the top of him. Oh, off the rim, no good. Capers with the ball. Capers to Bolden, looks, steps out of the three-point line and comes up short. Big rebound by Gaines Jr. Back out to Capers. Back in the corner to Gaines Jr. for three, in and out and all around. And look at that. Look at Thomas digging hard for the ball, but no good. Kevin Thomas tried everything to get that ball. Puts it on the floor to Jamal Reynolds. Fouled in the act of shooting. Kevin Vassell does not like that, Coach Vassell. He's thought it was all ball. It's not the way the guys in the gray shirt saw it, so Jamal Reynolds will go to the line. Coach Vassell pleading passionately with referee number 26, Ryan Lutz, to no avail. Great shot by Reynolds. Nothing but mesh. 25-23, London over Cape Breton. 1:06 remaining in the first quarter. Second free throw for Jamal Reynolds. And it's good. All right, Williamson on offense for London. Calls Bolden out to pick the screen, but no. Walks right by it. Williamson cuts inside, puts the ball on the floor, and loses it. Chris Johnson picks up the defensive board, runs the floor with Tanner Gettings. There's his first points as a Cape Breton Highlander at home. Tanner Gettings, number 32, to Cape Breton, regains the lead. Williamson, Bolden, Gaines Jr. inside to Bolden. Bolden backing off Gettings. Turnaround jumper. No, he tried to pass inside. Great play by scramble for the ball and out of bounds, and they're going to call it London Lightning ball.
Do you have a Sharpie? I can use.
Reynolds scrambled for that ball. It was a toss-up, but referees saw the last person to touch it was Reynolds himself, so it's Lightning ball inbound. Fresh shot clock. Capers. They don't even need the shot clock now because there's only 15 seconds left in this quarter. Capers on Massey. picked by Bolden. Creates some space for him. 5 seconds. Takes it in. Finger roll. What do they call here? That's an offensive foul. That's charging. So that negates the entire offensive sequence for the Lightning. Cape Breton retain a 26-25 lead. 3.4 seconds. They've got definitely got a chance to make a shot here with 3.4. Radiant bound to 2 on the clock. Massey for a three-pointer from way out. Oh, off the front of the rim and almost. At the end of the first period of play, Cape Breton 26, London 25. The Cape Breton Highlanders would like to thank our local sponsors who make this whole season possible. Boston Pizza, we will make you a fan. Boston Pizza is a Highlanders premium sponsor. Seaside Communications, we live here. Travel Lodge, the official residence of your Cape Breton Highlanders. Canadian Tire, made for life in Canada. Nova Imprint, your local authorized Xerox agency. Mayflower Mall, service happens here. Pepsi, made in Cape Breton. Cabot Power Sports, the trail starts here. Metro Sanitation, keeping our community clean. Breton Law Group, guidance that makes a difference. Samson McPhee, the Highlanders' official immigration lawyer. Center 200, which is our home here and the proud home of the Cape Breton Highlanders. Burns Dentistry, the official dentist of the Cape Breton Highlanders. Well, I'm joined now by Matt Giorgio again at the end of the first quarter. Matt, Bruce Massey with 9 points and a couple of lead changes. It took almost three quarters of that first quarter for Cape Breton to grab the lead, but they seem to be comfortable there.
Definitely a good game, Stephen. Again, a bit of a slow start for the Highlanders, but then they get back in gear, just similar to last night. And it's a pretty evenly matched game so far, but I think the Highlanders are stepping up their defense at the end of that first quarter.
I sure do. A couple of offensive fouls going the way for Cape Breton in this game. There's some pretty aggressive blocking and crossing out there on the offensive side for the Lightning, have you noticed?
It's definitely getting physical, which is always makes the game a little bit more interesting. A little scary if you're the coach or owner and seeing your players in a physical game, but it does make it more interesting for the fans.
Kevin Ware Jr. takes a foul there. First foul of the second quarter, 11:37 in. Cape Breton up by one. That'll be a non-shooting foul, so Bruce Massey will inbound from the offensive baseline.
And Tanner Giddings is in the game. Tanner was unable to play yesterday, so he started today. It's nice to see him back in the roster.
6'10 center from Windsor, California, making a difference underneath the basket there. He got himself 2 points, his first 2 points at home here. Great D right there. Giddings keeps it, feeds it to Jamal Reynolds, who's not afraid of this move. Oh, look at that.
Wow.
What a gorgeous, gorgeous
wow.
move. Kisses the glass and in.
I thought for sure that was going to be blocked, Stephen. But he put it up high enough off the glass. It was quite an impressive shot.
For sure.
The Highlanders have been getting turnovers here, tough stops, and a lot of transition scoring. And I think that's what the Highlanders are going to be known for this season. Ooh, I think he got away with a bit of an elbow on that one.
I sure do. That's in 15. Williamson knocks that down for two.
And Steven, that was a tough shot, even though he put that elbow out there, getting it hit and then going up and elevating and being able to make that shot. That was definitely a tough
professional
shot.
Professional athletes, they can do it all. There's Massey underneath. He's not afraid of being there. And look at that. What a nice touch over the top, eh?
There's that short game we talked about yesterday, Stephen. Bruce is the best in the league, I think, at that short game for a guard.
No question of that. There's Maurice Bolden pulls up and off the rim. No good. Rebound by Jamal Reynolds back the other way. Running the floor. There's a glance. Takes it right inside. Puts it on the floor to Giddings. Giddings, nice. Good eyes by Giddings to give that to Johnson coming down the middle. Unfortunately, couldn't get it. Williamson, oh, he heard the footsteps.
He did.
That's what they say. He heard the footsteps.
That's why you got to run back, Steven. Doesn't matter whether you think you can get to that player or not. You have to run back, and just the fact that...
Just the sound of your feet coming in.
That's right. And that was lucky for the Highlanders because there was almost a four-point turnaround. We missed a little bunny. Two opportunities there. Lightning would have had the easy two. Would have been a four-point turnaround.
CK and Zimmerman step into the game. Christian Kabongo into the game. Number five and Taquan Zimmerman into the game now for Cape Breton. Zimmerman coming across half. Switches, gives the ball to Reynolds, and he runs into the key looking for it, but no good. There's Kenny Jones. Back up to Zimmerman.
Kabongo's got a wrap on his hand. I hope that doesn't affect his ability to shoot.
Beautiful play. Kenny Jones was open in the paint. Reynolds saw, or Zimmerman saw him, fed it to him, and he got it. Kenny Jones.
He put his shoulder down a little bit there. I think the other player took a bit of a flop, perhaps.
Oh, good try by CK. Knocks it out of bounds, but 24 on the shot clock. So that did touch the rim.
I like what happened there, Stephen. The Lightning coach just asked the players, what are they in? What are they running? And they all respond at the same time. It's a well-coached team that does that.
Yeah, exactly. Communication, knowing they're on the same page, singing from the same sheet of music, as they say.
And that's why they've won championships in London.
That's for sure. Here comes Phillips to make a screen. He does. Cuts inside. Williamson kicks it back out to Ware. Looking for three. No good. Fighting hard. Oh, Maurice Bolden. Ball's on the floor.
Loose balls.
Phillips gets it. Pitches it back outside. Oh, Bab Harrison's into the game. Ooh, what a shot. First shot of the game for Bab Harrison.
That was way out.
Number 11, Jalen Bab Harrison, 6'4 guard from Ajax, Ontario, gets his first. Oh! Reynolds with more acrobatics for the Cape Breton Highlanders.
Jamal, he finds a straight line to that basket, and he goes hard and fast, and if you're in the way, you're going to foul. And that's what he's good at, is drawing those fouls, getting on the line. And he shot really well from the free throw line yesterday, as he normally does. Hopefully we won't jinx him here today.
Reynolds to the line. Short. He knew it. Misses the first one. 32-30 with 9 minutes left in the first half of this game. Cape Breton on top. Reynolds a chance to make it a three-point lead here if he can make this second free throw. Nice shot, Reynolds.
Zimmerman's picking up near full court here.
That's his 10th point of the half for Jamal Reynolds. Ware right to the glass. Beautiful run inside there.
Ware's
laying
got
it in
quickness
with the right hand.
He showed some quickness there for sure. You've got to respect that that quickness and stay in front of him.
Jones inside. Bit of a sky hook. Nice.
Little half hook, that's very hard to stop.
Little half hook, hard to stop.
Doesn't matter if you're oversized, you can if you master that little half hook.
Oh, Bab Harrison looking for his second three, but no good. Nice play by Jamal Reynolds to keep that, take that defensive rebound and keep it in bounds. Jones puts it on the floor and...
It's going to be a lightning ball. Lightning ball.
Lightning ball, okay.
Yep. Kenny Jones.
Just a missed dribble by Jones.
Missed the dribble. Sir. I think he got excited. He saw another back down coming.
That's right.
Made the move without the ball.
That's exactly right. He can be forgiven for that. He's playing a heck of a game. There's Williamson. Cutting inside. Nice block. They're going to call that a foul on, I think, Jamal Reynolds. No, they're going to call it on
Kenny Jones.
Kenny Jones, that's right.
Yeah, Jamal blocked it, but Kenny got him, I think, on the lower end.
6'7 forward from Philadelphia, PA to the line. Garrett Williamson, number 15.
So we have
Williamson with about 10 points in this game.
We have a three-point game, 35, two-point game now, 35-33 for the Highlanders. Shake it up.
Oh, almost a putback. No good. But Reynolds fighting hard for D. He grabs it. Gives it to Quan. Chris Johnson loves to shoot. Loves to shoot. No good there, though. Really short. Look at Kenny Jones grabbing that air ball underneath. Spin around and in. Oh, are they going to call it? No,
no
basket.
No shot. That was the right call by the referees, Stephen. Kenny was fouled, bringing the ball down.
Yep. Fouled to number 11, Jalen Babb Harrison.
It's going to be Highlanders ball on the baseline.
We're not going to call that shooting. That's Highlanders ball on the baseline. That's right. Christian Kabongo inbounds right to Kenny Jones. Finds Zimmerman up top. 12 in the shot clock. Inside to Jones. Boy, he likes it in there tonight. Putting his back into it, and there he is.
There's that half hook again.
Little half hook again. Williams Jr. back into the game. Williamson trying to find some room there. Oh. Keeps possession, takes a foul, going to the basket. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, so he shows some strength there, keeping a hold on that basketball. He almost lost it. And he was fouled. It looks like he's going to be on the line to shoot.
Williamson back to the line. 37-33, Cape Breton. 7:18 remaining in the first half of this second game at home here for the Cape Breton Highlanders. Currently 2-1 after a great win last night. Here's Williamson. Nothing but mesh.
Yeah, down 21 last night, Stephen, in the second quarter. Came back where I think we're up maybe even 10 or 11 at one point, and then the Titans fought back hard, hit some big threes last night.
And he makes both of them.
But luckily, the Highlanders were able to pull it out in the last minute.
Yeah, it was just a fantastic game. And these guys look like they've got lots of energy, considering that was only about 16 hours ago that end of that game happened.
It's definitely worrying when you've...
Kenny Jones, turnaround. Be good. Ooh. No good.
Looked nice like it was going to drop.
Oh, no. Reynolds, unlucky.
That was a tough shot flying through the air almost horizontally. I'm surprised he landed on his feet.
Williamson for London. Slowing things down here, 10 on the shot clock. Babb Harrison tries another long-range one, but no good.
Highlanders fought after the same ball there.
Well, he's going to make one. You got to keep trying them from the same spot. You're going to eventually make him. Babb Harrison gets his second three.
Can't give a good shooter the same shot twice in a row,
that's
Steven.
That's for sure.
And the London Lightning have regained the lead by one. Zimmerman.
Daquan Zimmerman. Nothing but mesh for Zimmerman.
Now that's what Zimmerman used to do to the Highlanders when he played for Halifax Hurricanes last season.
How many times did he come in the third or fourth quarter and hit that crucial three that stabbed the heart to take the sword and drive it into the Highlanders as opposed to use it on the opponent. Christian Kabongo with the ball now, and you're right, his hand is wrapped. Doesn't seem to be affecting his play. Zimmerman. Nice, back to Jones. He doesn't look at three very much, but maybe he should. Beautiful shot.
Yeah, we don't see that from Kenny very much. Usually he's looking to swing the ball when he gets it at the three, so when he hits that, he's got to keep the defender honest. That's going to make it tough to guard.
That's for sure. Williams Jr. cuts inside.
Oh, we got a foul called.
Foul going to the basket. Jamal Reynolds. It's been a pretty, Cape Breton have been a pretty disciplined team. They only grabbed four fouls in the first quarter. That's only their second of this, or third of this quarter.
Yeah, compared to the first couple of games where we had 70 fouls among the both home and away teams, which really slowed the pace of the game.
Timeout called.
I think it's immediate. Yeah, we have a timeout. I'm not sure if it's a media timeout. It's a little bit late for a media timeout, but I'm not sure anyone has called a timeout this game. Or this quarter, anyway.
5:24 remaining in the first half of the game. Cape Breton 43, London 38. They've got to be happy, I think, with the way they've played so far today against the defending champion London Lightning. Right from the beginning, this game has been. I think London had a 6-point lead was the most they had, and Cape Breton just kept them close and stayed determined on defense. And I think that's the difference. As coach, I said that to the coach Fitz Gonzalez before the game. What did you say in the dressing room last night, Coach? Because it really worked. And he said, well, I just got mad at them. I was mad at them. He said, they listened, but I was mad. But I was proud, He said it was a character win to be able to come back with that deficit last night. That did a lot for the team.
I was talking to some of the players as well, Stephen, today about halftime, and they said they knew coach would be mad, and he was, and they focused as a team to keep their composure going into the second half, and that's what they did. And they started the second half strong, chipped away at that lead, got it down to 6 or 8 by the end of the third quarter, and then took over early in the fourth. Titans came back strong in the final minutes of the game to tie it up. And then we had Bruce Massey with 4 seconds, a quick inbound to Bruce Massey, dribbled up the court looking for that foul, leaned into the player, it looked like the right call, and he was on the line with 0.7 seconds left and hit 2 of the shots, and that was the end of the game. The Lightning had no timeouts left, so they were forced to do a Hail Mary pass from the baseline, and it just didn't work out.
Well, that's what Cape Breton needed, was a home win in their first game, and they certainly got it. They're in nice shape here in the first half of this game. I want to say that the Riptide aren't showing their game right now. Their game is not being broadcast. So we welcome viewers of the Riptide to the Cape Breton Highlanders game here. Highlanders ahead of the London Lightning right now, 43-38, with Williams Jr. on the line, number 31 for Lightning, shooting a free throw, and it's out and in and touchback. But no, missed both of them. 5-point lead for Cape Breton.
Almost a tip there, Steven, so they need some stronger box outs on the free throws. I've seen a couple of those today so far.
Well, Chris Johnson running the full cross court to take that pass. Reynolds switches Zimmerman. Zimmerman tried to feed inside a tight. Oh, Joel Ndondo's into the game.
That was
number
good
15.
Defense.
That was good defense. There wasn't much room there for him. Hard pass by Moon.
A little bit too much.
Kevin
zip
Ware
on
Jr.,
that.
A lot of zip on that. He couldn't grab it, so that's out of bounds. Good turnover, Cape Breton here. Just under 5 minutes remaining in the second half.
And I see a shout out to Frankie on YouTube here. I assume that's Frankie McDonald, beloved weatherman.
Cape Breton's beloved meteorologist, Frankie.
Oh, great
McDonald.
Pass.
Great guy,
great
and loves the team.
Free pass by Kabongo, CK. Unfortunately, Joel Ndondo couldn't finish on that.
Capers for 2. As I was saying, Matt, before you sat down, Marcus Capers, this must feel like a home game for him because this place is full of capers.
I see what you did there, Steven.
Oh, good attempt. And Dondo, that's 2. Couldn't finish on either of those last 2 offensive rushes. Look at that running the floor.
Oh,
wow.
Lucky. Got lucky on that.
Got real lucky on that. Zimmerman comes back the other way. Nice ball to... he just knows how to use the glass, this guy. He just knows how to use
the glass.
Use the
glasses. See how he used his body on that?
Yes.
He put his body between the player, leaned in, gave himself some space, made it too difficult to block. And, Stephen, the Lightning coaches were not happy on that last play where Xavier Moon went for a layup. They felt he was hit and unlucky there.
In and out for Moon again. That's 2 in a row for Moon. Johnson. Whoa. Good try by Chris Johnson. I wasn't able to finish that. Williams looking for a 3 here. Well, he stepped out, had a look. Oh, look at that play. But, well, a lot of ball, a lot of possession change on there, but ends up in the hands of the Lightning.
Kirk Williams.
And Kirk Williams Jr. knocks it down for 2, making it a 3-point game. 45-42. Cape Breton Highlanders on top. Maurice Bolden looking to check back in the game here on the next break. Jamal Reynolds, what are they going to call? That's going to call an offensive foul here.
Yes, sir.
Offensive foul. Lots of substitutions coming in, Stephen. We got Bolden for the Lightning. We got Bruce Massey and Jabari Craig for the Highlanders. And A.J. Gaines coming in for Lightning. So we've got four players turning
fresh
over.
Legs back into the game here.
Yes, sir. So 3 minutes left. Highlanders up 3.
Talk to me a little bit about our new addition, number 22, Jabari Craig, 6'10 center. Talk to me a little bit about the upside of this player.
So Jabari's a rookie. He was out of university. He was drafted in the G League in the first round. Fortunately, was not held on the roster, and then we got the opportunity to pick him up. Jabari, we got a foul here on the Highlanders. I'm not sure if it's going to be shooting or not, Stephen, but Jabari actually started basketball quite late in life. I think it was maybe 15, 16 years old. He ran track and played other sports, so you can actually see from his body and the way he moves He's got a lot of control of his body, and that bodes well for a guy his size who can move as well as him. He's got some work to do in catching the ball, facing to the hoop, going strong. So I think he's got some work to do there, and I think he's a young kid who's willing to work hard and be a solid pro.
Well, he took the foul there, and Capers makes both his free throws.
We got Taquan Zimmerman bringing the ball up. He's getting pressured here. And there we go. There's great, great pressure and a great finish by Xavier Moon
to take the lead.
And we've got a timeout for the Highlanders. That's probably a good timeout here, Stephen.
I think so.
And that was good pressure on Taquan. One of the things that we saw yesterday in the Titan game, Stephen, when the Highlanders were coming back and the Titan needed to catch up, they weren't putting much pressure on the ball, and it seemed to us that the Titans might have been a little tired, and I think that affected them. Now, the Lightning brought in some fresh legs, as you mentioned a moment ago, and that seemed to pay off.
It did pay off right there. The Lightning were on the floor here almost an hour and 10 minutes before the game. They were well out practicing way before. I'm not sure if they flew in last night or flew in arrived in Cape Breton, but they seem to want to get out there and practice there just before the game today.
I think I saw them in the arena watching the game last night, so I think
they came in early.
They
came in yesterday.
So had a good night's rest, presumably, and we're ready to go today.
And got a chance to see their opponent last night.
That's right. Another reason to come, of course. And a lot of times, fans may not know that when teams come into arenas, they always have a shoot-around on the day of the game. So whether they arrive that day or the day before, the day of the game, usually about 4 or 5 hours, sometimes a couple hours before the game, they'll have a half hour, 1 hour light shoot around just to get their bodies warmed up. Helps reduce anxiety as well. So if players are a bit nervous, getting that nervous energy out early is helpful. And they run over some plays and then they're ready to go for game time.
Well, Matt, there's 2:40 left in the first half of this game, and it's been tight the whole way. The Lightning have Bolden, AJ Gaines Jr. They have Moon, Capers, and Kirk Williams Jr., Cape Breton with Massey, Reynolds, Johnson, Craig, and Zimmerman. Massey's got the ball now. Beautiful little pick by Jabari, and beautiful. Nice play by Jabari Craig there. Great pick. Moved inside, grabbed that. Pick and roll.
A great screen and roll, and it's good to see Jabari finish on those. He's had a little trouble in the first couple of games finishing on that screen and roll, so it's nice to see him do that. The Lightning, you may have noticed on that screen and roll, they really played high on it, pressuring the ball, so it'll be interesting to see if they'll continue that.
Craig takes another foul and a hold underneath.
It's going to be Lightning ball on the baseline.
That's the sixth team foul for the Highlanders, so I want to keep an eye on that. Gaines Jr. pulls up off the front of the rim and over the other side. There goes Zimmerman with the defensive board. Massey back the other way. Back to Zimmerman.
That's good to see the Highlanders in transition there, Steve. They pushed the ball up the court. They found they didn't have a good shot they liked, so they pulled it back.
Well, there's the 6'10", Jabari Craig making a presence underneath the basket for the putback.
There's the athletic body, big athletic body. Once he learns how to be more aggressive, that's going to help him.
Moon for two.
Moon's making a difference in this game, Steven. His speed.
He certainly is. Not only that, Matt, but he's rocking the teal Nikes tonight.
Yes.
Today, I should say. Zimmerman for three, off the back of the rim, way back out. Look at that.
Great
play
by
Reynolds.
Resetting it here, minute 22 left.
Jabari Craig way up high.
Clearing this out a little bit here. Trying to get the ball to Massey, but they're playing great defense on him. Great
defense
by the Lightning.
Nice defense by the Lightning. Williams Jr. with his left hand.
And the Lightning take the lead, Stephen, by 150-49. Strong defense from the Lightning to finish this quarter.
Under a minute left. Massey with the ball. Cape Breton on offense. Massey backing his way in off the glass.
Oh.
Great putback by Jabari Craig, number 22. To take the lead. How many lead changes has there been in this last minute or two?
That's the best few minutes we've seen from Jabari since the season started, Stephen.
Yeah, I'm sure the coaching staff are pleased with his performance here in the second quarter of this game. No whistle there. Good play. Oh Reynolds, great tip.
Double tip.
Oh, wow.
Yep,
wow.
We have a double tip here.
Alonzo Wright, referee number 28, calls
Lightning player tipped it.
And the Lightning player tipped it, and then off Jamal Reynolds.
Yeah, it was hard to see, but it looked like that's what happened.
28 seconds left in the half. Marcus Capers brings the ball across center.
So shot clock's...
shot clock's about five seconds. Four seconds difference. Bolden. Gaines Jr. pulls up. Boy, he's got a nice, beautiful release. Gaines Jr.
3 seconds left.
Too high for Jamal Reynolds, and that ends the half. At the end of the first half of this game, London Lightning 52, Cape Breton Highlanders 51, and a barn burner here at Center 200.
You want coach?
Coming up at this halftime, we have a musical performance by Rick Fu.
I'm joined by Cape Breton Highlanders coach Bernardo Fitzgonzalez. Coach Gonzalez, pretty tight game.
Thank you, Stephen. It's a good game so far. We can fix a few things in defense. Our offense is, the ball was sticking. We need guys to move the ball a little bit more, bodies moving. And when you see, notice when the ball sticks, turnovers, bad shots. And bad shots are turnovers, so...
Yeah, all right, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rick Fo,
Jabari Craig,
and I'm an international
student at TBU. You've seen out of him.
The reason for me to sing here is that Tyrone is my friend,
and
he asked me that, can you sing some sounds that make
people
jump, which is fast? And since I'm not a rock guy, so I have to learn some faster sounds.
Wonderful. Great game and good luck. And chatting with your guys in the dressing room. Good luck in the second half.
I appreciate it.
If you don't mind.
Thank you.
Thank you. This song's name is What About Now by Wise of Life.
Shadows fill an empty heart. This love is fading from all the things that we are. All not saying, can we see beyond the scars? Make it to the dawn. Change the colors of the sky and open up to the ways you made me feel alive. The ways I loved you for all the things that never die. Left you all the night. Love you, find you. What about now? What about today? What if you're making me all that love's meant to be? What if our love never went away? What if it's lost behind words we could never find? Baby, before it's too late. What about now? Sun is breaking in your eyes. Without a new day, this broken heart can still survive. With the touch of your grace, shadows fade into the light. I am by your side when love will find you. What about now? What about today? What if you're making me all that love's meant to be? What if our love never went away? What if it's lost behind words we could never find? Baby, before it's too late. What about now? Now that we're here, now that we've come this far, just hold on. There is nothing to fear, for I am my beside you, for all my life I'm yours. What about now? What about today? What if you're making me all that I was meant to be? What if our love was the one to be? What if you die the world? What if you meant to be? What about now? What about today? What if you're making me all that I was meant to be? What if our love never went away? What if you're making words, words we could never find? Baby, before it's too late. Baby, before it's too late. Baby, before it's too late. What about now?
Thank you very much. And next song I'm going to sing, I was planning to sing a song by a singer which is Canadian. And there was something wrong with my music, so I have to change it into another one which is also as classical as the one I'm planning to sing. The one I'm planning to sing is a song which is called Whatever I Do It For You. It's called by Breton Highlanders, which is I love so much. The one of the cleanest singers I love so much. And it's really my honor to share the stage with him, even though it's not the same time. But anyway, hope you enjoy. Thank you. Oceans are bad day after day, and I slowly go insane. I hear your voice on the line, but it doesn't stop the pain. If I see you next, I'm never. How can you see forever? Wherever you go, whatever you do, I will be right here waiting for you. Whatever it takes, or how my heart breaks, I will be right here waiting for you. I took for granted all the time that I thought would last somehow. I hear the laughter, I taste the tears, but I can't get near you now. Oh, can't you see, baby? You got me going crazy. Wherever you go, whatever you do, I will be right here waiting for you. Whatever it takes.
wonder how we can survive this romance. But in the end, if I'm with you, I'll take the chance. Oh, can't you see? Baby, you got me going crazy. Wherever you go, whatever you do, I'll take it right here waiting for you. Whatever it takes, or how my heart breaks, I will be right here waiting for you. Waiting for you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy the game. And welcome to Cape Breton.
All right, we're back for the second half of this game between the home team, Cape Breton Highlanders, and the London Lightning. Currently, the score, London Lightning 52, Cape Breton Highlanders 51. Some highlights from the first half. Kenny Jones leading all scorers on the Highlanders with 15 points, followed by Jamal Reynolds with 12, and Bruce Massey with 11 points. Xavier Moon having a heck of a game for the London Lightning, as well as Williamson and Bolden. We start the second half of this game with Moon, Bolden, Williams Jr., Williamson, and Ware Jr. on the floor for London. Tanner Giddings, Zimmerman, Massey, Jones, and Johnson for the Highlanders. There's an attempt by the Lightning for a score, but no good. Rebound by Kenny Jones, and Cape Breton go on the offense with Taquan Zimmerman. Zimmerman feeds the corner to Massey. Massey cuts baseline underneath, and Cape Breton ball with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Highlanders to inbound from offensive baseline. Massey to inbound. Looking for somebody. Better get it in. Right to Jones. Turn around. There it is. What a beautiful shot by Kenny Jones. 17 points for Jones. Now Williamson with the ball. Blows by Jones off the glass. No good. And they're going to call a foul on Chris Jones. A little push. He was able to get that rebound because of that little push. First foul for Cape Breton in the second half. Kevin Ware Jr. inbounds. Xavier Moon back to Ware Jr. Back to Moon. Moon all the way across to Bolden. Bolden to Williamson. Inside. No good. Good defense by Cape Breton. Zimmerman. Zimmerman gets a block from Jones. Back to Jones. He loses control of the ball, and it's turned over to Maurice Bolden, runs the floor with it. Kicks it back to Williamson. Sorry, that's Kirk Williams Jr. with a big three. Zimmerman, Jones, Johnson, I'm sorry. Tanner Giddings cuts across, gives it to Zimmerman, who pulls up for two and scores. Number two, Taquan Zimmerman for two. Tie game, 55. Foul on Taquan Zimmerman on the offensive run. That's a turnover. Lightning to inbound from the offensive baseline. Williamson to inbound. Moon gets free and pulls up. Long, right into the hands of Massey. Massey inside to Giddings. Giddings with a move on Bolden. Cuts along the baseline. Feeds it back out top to Chris Johnson. Gives it to Zimmerman. And that's a turnover. Nice block. Again, right to Williams Jr. Puts it off the glass and in. .942 remaining in the third period. 57 for London, 55 for Cape Breton. Chris Johnson for three from way downtown. Nothing but mesh. Boom. Williams Jr. to Williamson. Williamson working on right inside to Bolden and off the glass, and no, couldn't make it go. Rebound by Kenny Jones. To Massey. Well, boy, is Bruce Massey ever feeling it tonight. Another three for Massey. 61-57 Cape Breton, timeout. London Lightning. The Cape Breton Highlanders would like to thank some more local sponsors who help make all of this possible. Paul's Food Factory. I'll tell you, here in Cape Breton, if you're hungry, there's nothing like a Paul's Pizza Burger to satisfy that hunger. YMCA Cape Breton, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Hunston Cachafanis CPA, Pharmacy Wholesale Services, Pearl Realty, 902 Advertising, 1019 The Giant, the number one radio station in the market, and 103.5 New Country, Governor's Pub and Eatery. Check out Governor's, live music, 7 nights a week, CBI Health Group, and Ultramar. The Highlanders would like to thank all of our sponsors who help bring professional basketball to the Cape Breton market. Some other scores from around the league. A low-scoring game in St. John with the Halifax Hurricanes on top at the start of the third, 49-43. They're in the first quarter in St. John's Newfoundland, and the Moncton Magic are better than St. John's Edge by four. It's 19-15 Moncton against St. John's. The other two games happening in the league right now. And right here at Center 200 in Sydney, Cape Breton, the Cape Breton Highlanders have a lead of 61-57. On the London Lightning, Maurice Bolden with the ball, number zero. Back to Williams Jr., pulls up for two, in and out. Good offensive board by Capers. Capers runs the baseline, tries to release, gets fouled in the process, and he'll shoot two. Chris Johnson takes his foul. Marcus Capers on the line for the London Lightning. He's good on the first attempt. He's a 6'4 forward from Winter Haven, Florida. And he makes two. Kenny Jones moves inside, turns around. There's his little sky hook. He's got that half hook working like nobody's business in this game. I don't know how many points he scored with that little half hook. Cape Breton retain their 5-point lead. Ware Jr. cuts across, gives it to Moon, who gives it to Bolden, who finger rolls it in over the top of Kenny Jones. 63-60 Cape Breton. Nice play by Zimmerman. Coach Vassell wanted football on that, but no call. No score on that offensive rush. So there's Xavier Moon with the ball. Kicks it back to Capers. Capers runs right inside, and Kenny Jones gets called on the foul. Non-shooting foul. Fourth foul in this quarter by Cape Breton. Capers to inbound. 13 on the shot clock. Moon runs right around. Little pull up. Spins it around. Uses every bit of the rim, and it's good. Xavier Moon for two. Kenny Jones. Zimmerman right inside to Giddings. And he's going to get called a foul there on Bolden. That'll send Tanner Giddings to the line to shoot two. Tanner Giddings is a 6'10 forward from Windsor, California, number 32. New addition to the Cape Breton Highlanders lineup. He makes his second free throw. 64-62 with 7:11 left in the third quarter. And a beautiful play by Ware Jr., who's fouled in the process, and he'll shoot. They're going to call Justin Taylor on the foul to the head, sending Ware to the line. Kevin Ware Jr., 6'2 guard from Conyers, Georgia. Three-point play for Ware. Seven minutes left in the third quarter. Inside to Kenny Jones. He's not able to keep control of it. Pretty good pass by Justin Taylor. He found a seam there. Passing like Mahomes there into the seam. Unfortunately, Kenny Jones couldn't hang on to it. Well, it's a turnover. Here comes Kevin Ware Jr. Ware back up to the top. Kirk Williams Jr. Not able to make it go. Massey tries to pass inside. Should have been called a hold there, I think, on Giddings. And they're going to call it. They're going to call the hold on Kirk Williams Jr. It'll be a turnover. That's only the second team foul by London in this quarter. So Cape Breton will inbound with 18 on the shot clock from their offensive baseline. Inbound to Chris Johnson. Johnson working on Capers. Oh, over the top, in and out. Johnson gets his own putback, but no, not able to do it. That's Cape Breton's ball, 21 on the shot clock. Fresh, almost a fresh clock for Cape Breton. Chris Johnson had two chances at it there, wasn't able to make it go. A.J. Gaines Jr. into the game for London. He'll take out Kevin Ware. Chris Johnson to inbound. Puts it on the floor to Giddings, who pulls up and knocks it down for two. Tanner Giddings. That's Capers. Back out to Phillips. Phillips launches one and knocks it down for three. London up by two, 68-66. Ball inside to Bruce Massey. No room for Massey. Feeds it inside to Tanner Giddings, who gets the better of A.J. Gaines on that. Puts it on the floor to Jones, and he puts it off the glass and in for Kenny Jones for two. Tie game. Capers with the ball. Inside to A.J. Gaines Jr. off the front of the rim. No good. Rebound by Kenny Jones, and they're back up the floor. Massey with the ball in transition. Behind his back, he gives it up. Xavier Moon, and then takes the foul. Bruce Massey. Bruce Massey was trying to be a little precious there with the ball, trying to do the pass behind the back. Stolen by Xavier Moon. And Coach Vassell not upset. A little bit upset with the referee on that call, although the foul went for the Lightning, so not sure what more he was looking for. Go to Phillips. Up and down, and whoa, put back by A.J. Gaines Jr. What a put back by number 35. 70-68 for the Lightning. Chris Johnson cuts inside off the glass, and oh boy, just can't make it go. Good rebound by Bolden. Maurice Bolden makes that rebound. Gives it to Moon, back to Bolden, back to Moon. Moon to Bolden. Switches with Capers, 10 on the shot clock. Capers cuts inside, off the glass, no good. Put back by Phillips, no good. Again, ball comes out to Chris Phillips, and he gives it to Bruce Massey in transition and lays it in, Massey. Boy, tie game again, 4:30 left in the third quarter. Capers, they've London Lightning slowing this down now, setting up their offense. Xavier Moon with the ball. Moon way over to the corner to A.J. Gaines, going to pull up for three, short off the front of the rim. Put back by Capers, but no basket.
They can't do that.
Number 5, Christian Kabongo into the game, and number 9, Jamal Reynolds into the game for Cape Breton. That was no basket by London on that last play. Inbound by Tanner Giddings to Justin Taylor. Back to Giddings. The big man way up high. I'm going to give that to Massey. He's going to try and run inside. Nice defense by Xavier Moon on him. And he jumped into him. They're going to call it. Massey is a master of that. Wait until the defender's in the air and then jump into him. Take the foul and he'll shoot 2. Number 1, Bruce Massey, the line to shoot 2. Nothing but mesh on the first one. And off the back of the rim on the second one. Massey gets 1.
Okay, fans, let's help out our Highlanders. Let's go, Highlanders. Let's go. 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 Make some noise.
What a seesaw match we have here against London and Cape Breton. Changing the lead almost on every possession. Into the game. 6'7" forward, Garrett Williamson. He takes Capers out. Fresh legs for the Lightning. Technical foul. Bruce Massey gets to shoot. And he makes it. And it's a tie game again. And the ball possession is retained by the Cape Breton Highlanders. Inbound to Justin Taylor. Xavier Moon trying to keep him at bay. Gives it to Tanner Giddings. Giddings switches with Jamal Reynolds, who has a little trouble with the ball, but he's got a handle on it now. He decides to run in and try to put it up. And that's a foul, a shooting foul for 2. That foul will go against Maurice Bolden. Sending number 9. Jamal Reynolds to the line. Reynolds misses his first one. And he's good on the second one. And the seesaw match continues. 73-72, Highlanders. Moon to Williamson. Back to Moon. Inside to Phillips. He's going to be looking for Bolden up top. But no, he cuts inside, muscles his way to the basket, but is unable to get it, and they're going to call that. Bruce Massey couldn't control that defensive rebound. Accidentally knocked it out of bounds, so that'll be Lightning ball with a fresh clock at the baseline. Xavier Moon to inbound. Way outside to Maurice Bolden. He's working on Tanner Giddings. Williamson back inside to Bolden. Bolden puts his body into Giddings and tries to sneak his hand around but can't do it. Defensive board by Jamal Reynolds. He's back up the floor with it in transition. Oh, right to Taylor and Justin Taylor. Oh, finger roll into the basket for Taylor. 3-point lead for the Highlanders, 75-72. Gain slips, but recovers. Pulls up off the back of the rim, no good. Christian Kabongo with the defensive rebound and running the floor with it. He sees himself a nice pass inside to Giddings. Ball's kept turnover to London. On the floor, Williamson off the glass, a little too hard. Nice tip by Justin Taylor into the hands of Tanner Giddings. And good defensive stop by Cape Breton. Bruce Massey to bring the ball across center. 2:10 remaining in the third period of this game. Cape Breton with a 3-point lead. Kabongo up top. 6 on the shot clock. Looking for some support. Puts the ball on the floor. Got to get a shot away here. Reynolds. And there was no... the shot clock exhausted. So, ball turned over, and they'll take it on the far court. Far side of the court. Timeout for the London Lightning. 1:53 remaining in the third quarter. Cape Breton Highlanders 75, London Lightning 72. Around the league, 7:19 remaining in the third quarter, and Halifax is on top of St. John, 60-52. That's Hurricane 60, Riptide 52. And in the second quarter of the game in St. John's, Newfoundland, it's tied at 30 between the Moncton Magic and the St. John Edge. Moncton, undefeated in the Eastern Conference here in the Atlantic Division. And they're in a shooting match with the St. John Edge, and it's tied at 30. Here at Center 200... this afternoon, we've got a heck of a battle, a seesaw battle between defending champion London Lightning and the home team Cape Breton Highlanders, and the Highlanders got the best of them right now at 75-72. Timeout is over. On the court for the London Lightning, Williamson, Moon, Bolden, A.J. Gaines Jr., and Phillips. Cape Breton puts Giddings, Reynolds, Massey, Kabongo, and Justin Taylor. Inbound Lightning, and they're on offense. Xavier Moon to Williamson. Williamson tosses it to Phillips. Phillips looking for a long ball over to Bolden. He takes a move, moves inside. Good tip by Reynolds, out of bounds. 8 on the shot clock. Jalen Babb-Harrison into the game, number 11. Hill inbound to Williamson. Garrett Williamson with the ball. Inside to Bolden. Babb-Harrison. Gaines Jr. pulls up, and he's got a real nice touch in this game right now. 2 for Gaines Jr. Jamal Reynolds to Tanner Giddings up top. Jamal Reynolds, he doesn't mind going one-on-one against the big guys. Ball spotted back out. Taylor with 6 on the shot clock. Off the front of the rim. Recovery by Kabongo. Justin Taylor puts the ball on the floor. Babb-Harrison picks it up. Looks to go the other way. And a turnover. And Lightning had possession. Jalen Babb-Harrison. Gives it to Maurice Bolden. Williamson to Bolden. Bolden for 2. Off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound by Kabongo. Gives it to Bruce Massey. Runs the floor with it in transition. Up off the glass, no good. Foul. 2 shots for Bruce Massey. Looks like A.J. Gaines. Yes. Looks like A.J. Gaines Jr. Anthony Gaines Jr. with that foul. 6'4 guard. Number 35. Number 1, Bruce Massey to the line for Cape Breton to shoot 2. Bam! Massey's good on the first one. One for 2, but Taylor with the rebound, puts it back up the glass, but no good. Maurice Bolden comes down with the defensive rebound. Massey gets 1 of 2. And it's 76-74 with 19 seconds left in the third quarter. Lightning play for the last shot. There's a 2-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Williamson drives the hole, and it goes. And he'll shoot extra. Highlanders will have 4 seconds on the clock if Williamson makes this basket. In and out. And that's going to be Highlanders' ball with 2.1 seconds on the clock. Game tied at 76. Oh, so this is bonus. That was a foul on Jamal Reynolds. And the attempt to recover that errant. Oh, he misses it. Reynolds recovering the errant foul shot. He was fouled in the process. So he shoots two. He misses the first one. Tied at 76. 2.1 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Reynolds makes the second one. Puts Cape Breton in the lead with 2.1 in the game. Right into the hands of Bab Harrison. He's got to get the ball off. And he doesn't make it. So at the end of 36 minutes, it's the Cape Breton Highlanders 77, London Lightning 76. We'll take a small break for the third quarter, and we'll start the final period of this game in a few moments. Okay, Breton Highlanders would like to thank their Highland Girl Dancers cheer team, dance team, who have some incredible moves out there. The Highland Girls dance team, choreography by Lucy Wintermans, and the dancers are Sarah Lynn Burke, Nicole Drohan, Catherine Green, Michaela Berger, Shaylin Varnes, Ashlyn McNeil, and Taylor Hoban. Well, the Highlanders have 5 days rest here before they head to Moncton to play the Moncton Magic on November 30th. They'll return home for December 4th to play the St. John's Edge back here at Center 200. Then they'll go on the road again, play PEI on December 8th, but then they'll be home for a four-game homestand starting on December 13th. That's a 10 a.m. in the morning game. It's the school game here in Cape Breton where we have over 4,000 students coming to see the Cape Breton Highlanders playing their provincial rivals, the Halifax Hurricanes. There's lots of tickets available, season passes, flex passes, skyboxes, and tables. Just call Center 200 box office to find out an opportunity to come and see your Cape Breton Highlanders live here at home. Joined again by Matthew George, you're at the start here of the fourth quarter of this game. Leads changed a lot in this game.
A good third quarter for both teams, I would say. Lob pass went out of bounds, too high for Jabari from Jamal. A good start, third quarter. I think you have both teams played pretty well, pretty evenly matched. As you say, a lot of number of lead changes going on there. Looked like either team could have broke out at any moment, but they've held on.
Bolden rocking the half and half hairdo up. Oh, short. Kabongo recovers that defensive board. He fished. Whoa, what a nice play. Get in there. Nice play by Jamal Reynolds. Assist by Christian Kabongo.
A reverse layup, pretty impressive. Nice pass from CK.
Capers switches with AJ Gaines Jr.
Oh, we got Justin is hobbling.
And they're gonna call that
an offensive foul, Steven.
Offensive foul, ball going the other way, and that's a foul against AJ Gaines Jr.
Highlanders got lucky there, Steven, because Justin Taylor was limping and was out of the play, so it would have been down a man. Looks like he's going to try to stay in the game, though.
I've yet to mention this, but I'd like to mention the three referees in tonight's game. for today's game. Ryan Lutz, number 26, Alonzo Wright, number 28, and Matt Goble, number 90. It's a thankless job being a referee in any league. And we want to thank them for their efforts here today. They've kept pretty good control of the game.
I was talking to the referees actually just before this game, because they're the same guys who ref yesterday's game. They came to Cape Breton to do the doubleheader. And I asked them, is it more exciting doing a game like yesterday? A nice turnaround from Jabari. Is it more exciting to do a game like yesterday, which was really close? And they said yes. It's more tension, more stressful, but much more exciting.
Well, absolutely. Kabongo, a little grab on the hand there. He'll take a foul on that one. The guy beat him. Maurice Bolden beat him, so he gave him a little tug on the hand and sent him off balance. So they're going to call on sportsmanlike foul on that against Christian Kabongo. Kabongo went over and gave some love to the player that he assaulted there, so it's all good. Unsportsmanlike, Matt, that's...
Two shots in the ball.
Two shots in possession.
Yeah.
Bolden knocks it down.
This is a fortunate shot for the Lightning. It might give them a bit of a boost here.
That's right.
So the Highlanders will have to maintain their intensity, try to get a stop.
79-78, 10:42 remaining in the game. Gaines Jr. to inbound. Finds Capers. Marcus Capers. Bold and thought about shooting.
That's a good pass there, Steve.
Underneath to Williamson. Ooh. Strong D by Jabari Craig. That's going to be four fouls or five fouls on Craig, I think.
Both hands off the backboard, making sure that layup doesn't go in. I have to say that's probably a good foul.
I think so, too.
Otherwise, it would have been an easy
Jr.
layup.
At the line. Greenberg, New York native, 6'7 forward. Ooh. That can't go.
Off to the right. See if he takes a little bit more time to center himself on this free throw.
The multicolored sneakers on Williams Jr. One red and one whatever color that is. It looks like creamsicle maybe.
Out of bounds, Steven rolled off the Lightning. Highlanders got lucky on that one because the Lightning almost pulled that rebound down. I have to say, Steven, I've noticed a few free throws in today's game where the Lightning are able to get possession. Highlanders yes. got to tighten that up.
That's for sure. Williams outside to Reynolds. Bab Harrison working on Reynolds. Reynolds turns around. Kicks it out to Jabari, who's off the...
Oh.
Justin Taylor did everything but make that basket. Out of bounds. That's going Cape Breton way.
That's tremendous hustle. Tremendous hustle. A great example there, Steven. Justin had an almost amazing play on one end. He was disappointed he missed. But he made it back on the defense.
Make that play.
Exactly.
He was on the floor down at the other end underneath the basket, and he made it back to make that defensive play.
I don't know
play.
How he made that play, but I can tell you, this kid is strong, Steven. He's got upper body strength, and he moves quickly.
Bongo. Bongo looking like he's going to come inside, and he does behind his back. Pass inside to... Oh, and they're going to call that Lightning ball. That could have gone either way.
That looked like a good play. I think if he would have bounced it, usually you want to bounce that ball with passes like that. It makes it easier to get through. And I think if Jabari Craig had moved a little bit more aggressively, there would have been a bit of open space to catch that.
I want to give a shout out to some of our viewers. We've got some viewers in Jacksonville, Florida today, and we've also got some viewers from Phoenix City. Thanks for tuning in. I assume you're both cheering for the Lightning. Well, they're in a heck of a match here against the home team, the Cape Breton Highlanders. Lightning on offense. Gaines Jr. looking for some support. Bab Harrison comes out. Fakes the three, cuts into the paint, up off the glass and in. Nice play by Jalen Bab Harrison there.
That was a nice shot. We'll see if they apply pressure on the ball here. Normally they've been applying a lot of pressure on Zimmerman. They seem to be backing off a little bit.
Massey. Nine on the shot clock. Massey for three. Boy, oh boy, Bruce Massey.
Wow, that was almost a steal, Steven.
That was almost a steal.
Very lucky, nice shot.
He even looked down at the floor, saw the arc, stepped outside of it, and knocked down the three. There's Bab Harrison trying to offer
shot.
One back, but unable
wow,
to do it. Nice
rebound
by Gaines Jr. off
what
the glass.
A rebound.
You know, I got to say, Anthony Gaines Jr., AJ Gaines Jr., doesn't miss very often. Beautiful shot.
He's playing
shot
a
there.
Great game. And look, he comes up with the loose ball. It's going to be a Highlanders push here.
And we've got a tie game again.
That was an amazing rebound, Stephen. Those of you watching YouTube, you should rewind that. He went up high for that over a couple of Highlander players.
For sure. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention our Cape Breton Highlander fans watching on YouTube. Mr. Lovell watching from Victoria Mines, Cape Breton. Come on to the game sometime. Fantastic atmosphere at Center 200. We hope to see you here, but thanks for watching online today.
We've got a bit of a delay with something's on the floor. And Noah LaRose.
Team assistant Noah LaRose goes out and cleans it up, takes care of business out there at center court. Couldn't ask for a tighter game. Knotted at 82. Ball in the hands of Capers. Capers inside to Bolden. Bolden backing off on the defender, but he's going to call travel on Bolden. Got his feet moving there. Good turnover for Cape Breton. Give them a chance to get a couple points here. This is going to be a tight game right to the end. It feels like it's going to exchange leads all through this game. There's Zimmerman from the corner for three. Wow.
Big shot.
Beautiful shot.
Big shot. That's what Zimmerman needs to bring to this team, Stephen.
That's his meat and potatoes. That's what he's all about. The ability to knock down a tough three from a corner like that. Beautiful shot. And here's going to Bolden trying to answer. And he gets nothing but mesh and answers.
We just got to pause and play. The ball has gone out of bounds, and we got some subs coming in, I think.
We're trying to get Phillips into the game. Marvin Phillips sits. Oh, Marvin Phillips is out of the game.
Looks like they're doing the same play here.
Zimmerman for three again. Off the front of the rim this time. No good.
Oh, wow.
Reynolds
wow.
goes up and takes that ball away from two Lightning players.
Aggressive. Oh, Bruce
Massey to the basket. Beautiful play by Massey for two.
That's Bruce Massey right there.
That's his signature. That's his calling card, what he just did there.
You got it.
Capers trying to gain some ground on the inside there. Unable to. Probably take a foul there, was it?
Absolutely. He really drew the foul on Zimmerman.
Number two, Taquan Zimmerman, takes that foul.
It was a hard foul. But that's what Capers was going for, and he got it.
Sending 6'4 forward from Winter Haven, Florida, Marcus Capers, number 14 to the line, to shoot two. First one's no good.
Massey's directing Kenny.
Calling Kenny down low.
Yep, you gotta make sure they get these rebounds.
Makes the second one. 1 point game.
Here we go, running it again.
See if they can
Same
do it.
Play. Oh, they're looking for Kenny. He's looking for Kenny. No. He's trying to get Kenny inside, but there's good help.
Puts it on the floor to Jones. Backs in. Gets the ball stripped from him, but that's Cape Breton ball with six on the shot clock.
That's good help from Bolden, Stephen. They could tell that the play was they're looking for Kenny. And the Lightning were anticipating that and playing good help defense.
So with six on the shot clock, Cape Breton inbound from the offensive baseline.
I think Chris Johnson might have got away
good
with a bit of a push there.
And it's too much time. Yep. That's too much time. They weren't able to get that ball in.
You're right. Chris Johnson, I got to say, got away with a little bit of push on that one. So I think the Lightning probably deserved the ball.
Evened it out.
Good defense from Kenny Jones on that. Oh, and they
Capers
threw
a pass to nowhere. Out of bounds, turnover, Lightning. Highlanders ball. Marvin Phillips back into the game. Maurice Bolden, who's played a lot of minutes in this game.
Phillips is a big guy, Stephen.
He is a big presence in there. Taquan Zimmerman.
Push on that.
Bab Harrison takes a foul there. Xavier Moon checks into the game to give Bab Harrison a rest.
Moon's been playing well, Stephen. His speed has really helped help Lightning. It'll be interesting to see if they'll use Moon's quickness on Taquan.
Phillips with the crazy mohawk. Touches it out of bounds. Six on the shot clock again for the Highlanders. Let's see if they can convert this time. They've been playing flypaper defense on these inbounds, so let's see if we can get a man open here and get a shot away. 10 on the shot clock, I'm sorry.
Highlanders up one.
Oh, it's 8 on the shot clock, thank you. Highlanders up by one.
Hopefully they're aware of the shot clock here. Look, they're playing good defense again, Steven.
Garrett Williamson knocks that inbound out of bounds.
I can't help but wonder if fatigue is setting in here with the Highlanders, Steven.
True enough. Massey gets the ball. Back to Jones. Had a look at three earlier. Nothing but mesh for Kenny Jones. Leading scorer tonight for the Cape Breton Highlanders. Knocks another three down.
Great shot.
A to extend shot. The lead to four. Phillips. Gaines Jr. cuts inside. Backs off. Whips it around the horn. Ends up in the hands of Williamson.
Clearing
here comes
out.
Phillips for a screen. Way across to Moon again. Makes a move on Massey. Inside to Capers. Two on the shot clock. Capers off the glass and good.
That was a nice pass.
Beautiful play there. Nice offensive sequence by the Lightning.
Yeah, they needed that shot. They needed that basket, Steven.
They sure did.
Down two. They were down five. Chris Johnson with a three. Short. It was a tough look. It's going to be Lightning ball. Bruce Massey
no,
tipped it out of bounds. Lightning ball.
Lightning ball, yeah.
2-point game.
5:30 remaining in the game. Across center comes Xavier Moon. Phillips lays a screen for him. Back outside to Garrett Williamson. Phillips is screening all over the place here. Pitches out to, Capers off the rim, no good. Whoa, big Phillips big. With the rebound
big.
And puts it back and a foul.
Big rebound and the basket. Phillips showing his strength on that on the rebound there. And the put up. He's going to shoot one. We've got a timeout.
Game tied at 90.
5:12 to go. Highlanders have five fouls. London Lightning have two, so both teams have a few fouls to give, but Lightning has a bit more flexibility.
Well, it should be an exciting 5 minutes and 12 seconds of basketball to finish this game. I gotta say, they haven't really showed any kind of fatigue yet, the Highlanders, considering they played an intense game here last night.
Well, you know, we'll see when they come out. You can often see the fatigue, Stephen, in some lazy passes or passes that aren't as crisp as they should be. Also, you know, just the chatter, the talk between teammates when they're on defense. As players become tired, they don't talk as much. So we'll see if they're chatting with each other, communicating with each other well when they come out for this final 5 minutes. On the floor right now, we have a Mayflower Mall. Take your shot game, where a contestant has 20 seconds to make three layups and win a gift certificate from the mall.
There we go, that kid's got $50 in his pocket to spend for Christmas. Thanks to the Mayflower Mall for being one of the great supporters of the Cape Breton Highlanders and the Mayflower Mall take a shot game. It's take a layup game this year. I must say I'm happy to see the Highlanders completing their roster by getting Tanner Giddings back on the court.
Yeah, you know, 6'10", Tanner Giddings. He moves well as a big guy. He's got a good touch on the shot. So I think we definitely missed him first couple games. He was away on taking care of some personal matters and now is back. We also hope to have Aaron Redpath back soon. We think he might be ready to play in the next game. He's had a hamstring injury that he's been working through. And, you know, Aaron brings three-point shooting. He's got a couple years experience as a pro. And that's definitely going to be helpful for the Highlanders.
I remember Redpath to be pretty strong on the defensive end of the court as well.
Yeah, you know, he played for the St. John Riptide last year, and he definitely made his presence felt against the Highlanders, against other teams. So it'll be nice to have him on our side this time.
Phillips makes it a three-point play, so there's the lead again. Changing, London Lightning with the lead. 91-90. Reynolds. Oh, Zimmerman was wide open in the paint. Back to Jones. Jones goes the other way with it, gives it to Bruce Massey.
There's that Massey's right shot, and he got fouled.
Called.
And he got fouled.
And he got fouled going there, and that'll count.
And he held that strong, that ball strong on his hip, like we see Bruce do. It almost encourages the defender to try to slap at it, but Bruce has such a strong hold on it and has such a good hands that it usually draws a foul, and then he's able to pull it back out of his pocket and finish with a little scoop or a little half hook, just like he did there.
And it's good.
That's Highlanders up too, Steven.
Yep, 4:48 remaining in the game. Xavier Moon has been a big piece of the Lightning puzzle. Gets the ball back from Williamson, setting up, gives it inside to Phillips. Not really inside, sort of on the edge, and Phillips pulls up a straight-up two-pointer there. Good shot.
And Phillips, with his size, demanded some respect going to the hoop, so his defender had to back off, and that gave him his little jump shot. Yep.
And it's good, and it's going to shoot. That's a bonus shot for Chris Johnson. Good for Johnson.
Got a bit of a switch, I think, that happened there, and Chris Johnson got Xavier Moon, a smaller player, on his back. The pass, I have to say, Steven, was a little bit slow. I didn't think he was going to get through, but luckily Johnson grabbed it out of the air and was able to use his size advantage to score over Moon.
Johnson, nothing but mesh. North Preston, Nova Scotian's own Chris Johnson with a three-point play.
Yeah, it was nice to see Chris hit that shot. He missed a few earlier today, and I think that'll give him his confidence back in finishing the last 4 minutes of this game. There's Moon showing his speed, Steven, but unfortunately couldn't finish. Okay, Taquan Zimmerman looked like he had a three, but that Lightning got back really fast on that one. Great defense, and almost got a pass in, but it got tipped.
You know, we've seen these two teams from Ontario have come through here the last 2 days, play really tight defense and not give guys like Chris Johnson a lot of looks at three.
There really haven't been a lot of threes in the last couple of games. You know, normally in this league, there's a lot of threes taken and hit because there's a lot of great players in this league. But you're right, it's been a really tight play. And I think it's because on the screen rolls, you're getting the defense stepping up and pushing forward and pushing the teams out. There's a great pass.
Great pass into Chris Johnson. He wasn't able to use the glass effectively there, though.
That was a big miss there.
It was a big miss. Ware comes down the other way. Off the basket, he'll take a foul there.
So it was a three-point difference. That could have been a 5 or 6 point difference. Chris will shake that off, and we know Chris can score and he can play, and he'll shake that off, Steven, and we'll see him come strong in this next shot.
Kevin Ware Jr., number 5, makes his first free throw, and his second one's in and out.
2-point game.
It is a 2-point game with just around 3.5 minutes left. Jamal Reynolds to Kenny Jones, number 21, up top, looking for someone inside.
Lightning are playing really good D.
Really good D by the Lightning. This is championship team D by the Lightning here. Massey looking for three. Ooh. Wow. What are they going to...
He lost the ball!
So what happened there, Steven, is Bruce Massey was going to take a three. London player jumped out at him, put his feet up in the air. Bruce had to duck under the player's shoes not to get hit. Normally in that play, I think Bruce would actually try to take the foul on the three, but when the player's coming at you with his knees and shoes, I think he made the right decision, so he put the ball on the floor.
Yeah, he could have been eating some sneakers there. Instead, he ducked underneath. It made a move to the basket, got foul going there.
Yeah, the Lightning coach is suggesting that Bruce might have just lost the ball. But I have to say, there was another Lightning player coming at him pretty strong at the same time, so... I think it's, you know, it was one of those 50-50 calls, Steven, depending on the angle you saw it at. It could have been called either way.
Coach Vassell, he must be happy with this team, though. He's the championship team coming back. These guys look pretty strong this year. They look like they're built to make another run.
Championship team, lost a few players, but it looks like they still definitely have a good, strong roster.
Beautiful play by Jaquan Zimmerman.
It's off. They're calling an offensive foul.
They're going to call it
that
no basket.
That basket's not going to count. Wow.
Marvin Phillips taking the punishment and taking the charge. No basket. Ball goes the other way. Cape Breton up by two, 3:06 remaining in the game.
That was a big defensive play. I didn't see it, Steven. I can't call it, but it was a big defensive play.
Coach Fitzgonzalez showing with his legs that he may have moved. He may have created a little more of a block there than a charge. So
that's 3 points. Could have been up for the Highlanders, but taken away. The Highlanders are only up two now.
Caper sets up on top. Phillips backs his defender in, up to the rim, rolls out, no good, and they're going to call a foul on Jamal Reynolds.
That's Marvin Phillips.
Sending 6'7 Marvin Phillips to the line to shoot two.
Using his size and strength again, Steven.
When you look at the Cape Breton Islanders, they've got Joel Ndondo at 6'9, Jabari Craig 6'10. Tanner Gidding, 6'10". Talk to me a little bit about the importance of having big men on your team.
Well, you definitely want big men for shot blocking and rebounding in this league. A lot of big men in this league don't always score, but as long as they play tough, rebound, defend well, you can get a lot of advantage out of them. Now, you'll notice the Highlanders are with a small team right now on the court. Tallest player is only 6'6". I think our big men need a bit more time on the court. They're all young rookies or only a year into their pro career.
There's Kenny Jones working super hard on the offensive boards to get two and stretch the lead to three.
Kenny's playing a great game today, showing the old Kenny and showing what he can do.
Great play by Capers there.
Capers coming back when they need a basket. Capers has been delivering for them.
1 point game again, 2:05 remaining. Highlanders by one, 98-97. Jamal Reynolds with the ball to Kenny Jones. The leading scorer in this game, Kenny Jones.
Shot clock down to 10. We're gonna make, there it is.
Inside to Jones. And they'll get called for the foul there. He'll shoot two for that.
I think that was good foul because Kenny would have had an open layup and he doesn't miss those very often. And now he's gonna have some pressure on him on the free throw line. We have a timeout with the Lightning, Steven. And checking on the fouls, we've got 7 and 6, so both teams are into the bonus in the next foul, so they're gonna have to play solid D without fouling, otherwise they'll be sending each other to the line.
That's right, your seventh foul, it begins shooting then. It doesn't matter where the foul happens or who it happens to, you start shooting.
So I think the Highlanders have to be happy with whatever happens tonight. This is the team's fourth game. They've played the number one Moncton Magic. We're 4-0. Play them right to the end. That game could have gone either way. They beat the Titans, beat the Island Storm. This game with the Lightning can go either way. So I think the team has shown they can compete with anyone. And the league is as competitive as it always is.
Speaking of other games around the league, the Halifax Hurricanes currently have a 8-point lead on the St. John Riptide with 5 minutes remaining in the game. And the Moncton Magic they were tied at 30 the last time we checked. The start of the third, at the end of the first half, Moncton Magic had leading the St. John Edge 60-48. So Moncton looking to extend their streak to 5-0.
Looks like Halifax has been bolstering their roster. They started off a little slow with a couple of losses. Had a lot of turnover on the roster, which is new to them because the last few years, their roster was pretty solid. And they picked up Gabe Freeman, Gabe a former MVP of the league. And he actually started right away as soon as he landed in Halifax. I think he had one practice and they had him on the starting lineup. Made a big difference, I think, in their first win. And I suspect without seeing the game, he's probably contributing to their current play today.
Kenny Jones on the line to shoot two. This is the first one.
It's tough to hit a free throw, Steven, after your timeout is called and you're sitting on the bench and listening to direction from your teammates and your coach, and then you got to, stand on this line in front of an arena of fans.
Some of the greatest players in basketball history have had a hard time from the line.
You got it.
But he makes the second one and extends the lead to two. 99-97.
The Highlanders are... putting some extra pressure on.
Moon with the ball. Phillips sets the pick, gets the ball back, kicks it out to Capers from the corner for three, and he makes it.
Capers again, Stephen, answering the call for the Lightning. Capers is having a heck of a game. And that gives them the lead by one.
1:25 remaining in the game. Kenny Jones with the ball. London Lightning 100. Cape Breton Highlanders 99. Back to Bruce Massey. Behind his back. Fakes a shot.
Oh, he's anticipating a foul there.
He was too.
He ducked under it a bit too much, I think.
I agree.
So that was a big stop for the Lightning. Minute left.
It gives them a bit of clock possession here now. They can take a bit of time off this and maybe...
Greens are moving.
Five on the shot clock. Williamson going to look for a three here, probably, is he? Oh, it's going to be a tough one. Off the rim.
Oh. Foul is going to be. We've got some confusion. Foul's on
so
Jamal
fouls on
Reynolds.
Jamal Reynolds.
On the rebound. Marvin Phillips, Stephen. Using his strength, went up high for that rebound.
Jamal Reynolds had to climb him like a ladder. Oh, and he misses.
And this is a bonus situation
that
that's happening here.
That was a
bonus.
199, 46.6 seconds left in the game.
So this is going to be
by one. This is an important one here.
Important shot, important rebound if he misses. The fans are giving it to him. Calmly steps up and drops that one.
Maurice Bolden back into the game. Timeout, Cape Breton.
Two point game, Stephen. 46 seconds. Highlanders ball. So I suspect they will try to get a good shot. They're probably going to maybe do a bit of a clear out, I'm guessing, for Bruce Massey. They might do a little clear out for Jamal Reynolds, perhaps. And probably Kenny on the inside. So we'll see if they're going to try to go hard for a two to tie it up or if they're going to look for an opportune three to take the lead.
Well, it's been a great weekend for the Cape Breton Highlanders. They've been able to come home with their new team, show their fans just what they're all about. And as I said in the first night, I felt that the team was built, this team's built to win, and I think with the guidance of Coach Fitz Gonzalez, we're in for a pretty exciting season for our home fans. We really want to invite all of you in Cape Breton to come and experience the National Basketball League of Canada's Cape Breton Highlanders at home at Centre 200. It's more than just basketball here at the game. There's games for the kids in the concourse, everything from ages 5 to 95.
Stephen, I can't tell you how many fans I've talked to over the last two seasons that have said, look, I didn't even know I liked basketball until I went to a Highlanders game. Because they realize that entertainment experience that they have in this arena.
There's no sport where you can get closer to the action than basketball.
You got it. Here we go, Stephen.
Here we go. 46. Important possession by Cape Breton right now. Zimmerman across center.
To Chris Johnson.
Jamal Reynolds comes up with the ball.
Wow.
Massey.
Setting it up. Chris Johnson had a shot there, a tough shot. He almost made it. And Jamal Reynolds comes up with that loose ball. Amazing.
Chris Johnson.
Oh.
Fouled in
and
the act
of fouled.
Shooting a
three. He's taking three.
Wow. Just like last night.
And Steve, you know, that foul, that ball hit the corner of the backboard. I thought it was going in. I thought he actually had.
Chris Johnson to the line for three. As a result of that foul in the act of shooting a three, he'll shoot three uncontested free throws. He makes the first one. It's a tie. No, it's 101-100. Johnson.
You gotta stop this. There's no way.
And he makes the second one. Tie game. 101-101.
We have a tie games here, Stephen, and there's some confusion with timeouts. How many timeouts are available?
Yeah, the Lightning believe they have one left. I think after this, the referees are discussing this now, Alonzo Wright and Ryan Lutz discussing the timeout situation.
Yeah, and that's the right thing to do, Stephen, is if there's uncertainty, have a conversation, figure it out.
I'm inclined to agree with Coach Vassell. I do believe one of those timeouts that were called were a Cape Breton Highlanders timeout, so I do think they have one left in this. This timeout becomes very important. Here comes Ryan Lutz, referee Ryan Lutz.
So the referees now are discussing it with the scorekeepers.
Referees are working this out with the official scorekeepers here.
So Stephen, what do we have here? We have a tie game, 1-on-1. We got Chris Johnson on the line shooting one. 22 seconds.
So the clock belongs to the London Lightning. What would be the strategy here if Chris makes this shot?
Well, if Chris makes this shot, they may want to run it. Yeah, I'm hearing the coach actually call out last shot for London, so they're going to run the clock down. Whether Chris makes this or not, they're going to run the clock down, probably down to about 6 seconds, and then try to make that shot.
Chris makes it. Cape Breton up by one with 22 seconds left.
Phillips coming in. So 22 seconds left, Highlanders up one, London ball, no shot clock. What else do you want if you're
really,
a fan?
Exactly.
What else do you
this
want?
This is what it's all about. Moon comes back for it. He's Mr. Reliable, Xavier Moon back. 19 seconds left. Williamson across center with the ball. Setting up for last shot. There's Phillips looking to make a screen here. Massey around. Williamson kicks it out to Moon for three. And he makes it with 3.4 on the clock. What a shot by Xavier Moon.
Wow, he had a great look. Great look. Great look. Steven, didn't this happen last night?
This happened last night. Same thing.
3.5 seconds left. Wow.
Wow. That was a killer by Xavier Moon.
He had a great look. They got him the ball. I didn't think they were going to find him, but they found him. Spotted up, nothing but net, brings the Lightning up by two, 104-102. Now the Highlanders have the ball.
What's the play here?
Well, with a timeout, they have the option of bringing the ball to the front court, which I'm sure they're going to do. 3 seconds is plenty of time to catch the ball, take maybe two dribbles if they need it, and a shot. They may try to lob it inside, may try to do a post-up. To Kenny Jones, most likely, if that's the case. Otherwise, I'm guessing they're going to go for Bruce Massey, try to run him off a couple of screens, get Bruce the ball as close to the three-point line as possible, and then allow Bruce to take a dribble, maybe a second dribble, and take that shot, maybe a pump fake. If you're going to do a pump fake, Steven, you're only going to have time for one dribble, so you got to keep that in your mind. It'll be interesting to see what happens. But regardless of what the offensive team is planning, the defense is also planning something, and you never know what's going to happen.
Moon, Bolden, Capers, Ware, Williamson for Lightning. Cape Breton brings out Johnson, Jones, Massey, Reynolds, and inbounding the ball is Taquan Zimmerman. Nope. I'm sorry, inbounding the ball would be Chris Jones. Taquan Zimmerman set up way over in the corner. 3.4 seconds.
I think what's going to happen here, Steven, I think Massey's going to screen for Zimmerman, which is actually a deceiving screen. They're actually going to looking for Massey.
It's short. And that's the game. London Lightning win 104-102. An exciting down to the buzzer finish. Well, the Cape Breton Highlanders split their home opening 2 games, 1-1, and extends their season record to 2-2. On behalf of the Cape Breton Highlanders, I'm Stephen Antle, and with Matt Giorgio, thank you very much for viewing, and we look forward to seeing you again at our next home game here, taking place on December 4th against the St. John's Edge. Take care of each other, and we'll see you next time.
We want to thank you for coming out.
Good job, Chris.
Good job, man.